Jai Hind to all my dear children. So today we are on the last topic of this lesson, synthetic fibers and plastic. For today the topic is, children, plastic as a material of choice. So what do this topic mean? Plastic as a material of choice is, do we have choice to use it or not? Yes, this topic means that plastic is not a mandatory or any very essential thing without which we cannot live. Okay, so on one hand, children, we can see that day to day or every time in news we come to listen or we see also in our surrounding that plastic is responsible for different kinds of pollution in our environment. On contrary to this, on other hand, we can see that all of us, we are surrounded by the things made up of plastic and we use them every day in our day-to-day life. So now the question is, what is the solution? Should we use the plastic or we should not use the plastic? See, it depends upon us. It depends upon us only to use this plastic or to not. So for this, to decide where to use and how to use, let us read this topic and understand the judicious way to use the plastic. So for this, let us read the characteristic property of plastic. Children, in this points, you are going to read simultaneously the characteristic property of both synthetic plastic and synthetic fibers. So the first point or the first characteristic property is, plastics are light in weight. Are light in weight? Yes, synthetic plastics are very much lighter in weight as compared to your wood metals. So incomparable to your wood and metals, you can find that plastic materials are very light in weight, and that is why we prefer to use the plastic material in place of wooden things or any material things. See, if we take the example of wooden chair, so that is heavy, and plastic chairs that are lighter in weight. If you use the chairs made up of metal, that is iron, that would be also very heavy and it requires maintenance, that if you will not paint your iron chairs, it may get rusted. Okay, so, and there is nothing such cases with plastic because it is non-reactive, it is inert in nature. So that is why these plastics are good for our home furnitures. See, synthetic fibers are much lighter than natural fibers as jute, cotton and wool. Okay, next characteristic property, plastics are strong and durable. Strong and durable. Strong means, yes, it is very strong, it cannot be broken easily. And durable means it lasts long. If it cannot be broken easily, that itself means it will last for a longer time. See, please read, children. Synthetic plastic have a vary in their tensile strength. Vary means different. Different synthetic plastic have different tensile strength. Tensile strength means you can see here in the left hand side, this is the tensile structure replaced yarn. What do you mean by tensile means strength? Tensile strength means the strength which an object can bear high tensions without being broken. This is what you mean by tensile strength. Tensile strength means it is a resistant property of a material to breaking under tensions. Means if you just stretch it or if you just provide the force on it, it will not get broken down. Okay, see here, next thing. In general, the synthetic plastic have much less toughness as compared to metals and alloys like steel. So synthetic plastic have much less toughness, means these are not very hard. But if they are not hard, that doesn't mean that it is not strong enough. If it is not hard, then also these plastics, see, are reasonable strong and last longer. So as you have read that we have talked about nylon fibers, those nylon fibers were even stronger than your steel wires. So synthetic fibers have very high tensile strength as compared to natural fiber. Yes, we have talked about the same also, that natural fibers just like cotton and silk and wool, these may get broken down on applying the high pressure, but the these synthetic fibers or synthetic plastic will not get broken up into broken so easily. Okay, next point, insulating property. So this is the best property because of which the plastic is a part and parcel of our life. Synthetic plastic and fibers are insulators. Insulators means these do not allow the heat or electricity to flow through them. That is why wire cables, see here it is, wire cables are covered with any suitable plastic. Handles of pressure cooker, frying pan, these are made up of thermosetting plastics. Plastics are non-reactive. Next point, plastics are non-reactive means these do not react very often with the water, air and soil. So synthetic plastics and they are also non-reactive to your acids, alkalis, you have read beforehand. So thus these are non-biodegradable. If these plastics are non-reactive, they do not react with water and air and soil. So they will not corrode. If they will not get corrode and they will not the corrosion will not take place. So these plastics will last longer. Synthetic plastics or polymers are not affected by acid and alkalis, as I have told now. The natural polymers such as cotton, wool are damaged by acids and alkalis. Yes, you can see very nicely that if you pour a small drop of acids on your any acid on your handkerchief or on your shirts, and the same acid if you put on a small drop of acid you put in your bucket, you can find the difference. That bucket is not getting that much damaged as comparison to your handkerchiefs and shirts. So appearance and workability. Most plastic except bakelite and melamine are translucent and transparent. So these can be colored in any colors and can be given any shape. So as you have read that because of this translucent and transparent properties, your synthetic plastics are used as your lenses. These are also used as the glasses in your windows and doors. Okay, lastly, plastics are cheaper. Plastics are cheaper than metal. Yes, we do agree with this. These are cheaper than metal because of all these property, children. Because of all these characteristic property, these plastics are used in our daily life. Okay, so this is how, means if the question is asked that what are the favorable characteristics which make the plastics part and parcel of our life? So you are going to write all these points. Okay, next point we are going to study, plastic and the environment. So children, let us move to the next topic, plastic and environment. What is the effect of the plastic on our environment? See, on daily basis, on our daily routine, as it is written here, we generate a lot of waste of various kind. So some waste can be degraded very fast. Some waste means it takes months to degrade, while some waste do not degrade even in several years. So depend upon the decomposition or degradation property, the waste is divided into two, means the waste which we generate, we can divide it into two parts. One, we can call it as a biodegradable substance or waste. Another, we can call it as a non-biodegradable substances. So as the word it is written here, bio means life, degradable means those substances which can be degraded by living things. Living things means it can be degraded by small bacteria, fungus. So those substances which can be degraded, let us read this definition, the substances which can be decomposed or degrade to harmless substance. Harmless means it is not harming the environment. Through the natural process such as bacterial action over a period are called biodegradable substances. For example, kitchen waste means all the peel outs, all the things which are coming from the vegetables, those kitchen waste, leftover food, paper, clothes, dry leaves, these all comes under the biodegradable substances. Next heading is non-biodegradable substance. So let us split the word. Non means which cannot be, bio means which cannot be degraded with the help of the bacteria and fungus. So Let us look upon definition. The substances which do not decompose to harmless substance through the action of air, water or bacteria over a period of time, those substances are called as biodegradable substances. So for example, yes, now this is an important thing. Plastics comes under the example of non-biodegradable substance. It cannot be degraded by either water, air or bacteria, and that is why the plastic remains in our environment for a longer period of time. See, aluminium, metal cans, glass, DDT means this is a chemical which is used as insecticide in our crop fields. Now next is synthetic materials. Synthetic materials, plastic and synthetic fibers are non-biodegradable. I have underlined this so that you do not get confused or you do not forget to look this line. So these are non-biodegradable, and the materials or things made from such substances, if they are non-biodegradable, then these materials are buried under the soil or left on the earth surface exposed to air, these will be remaining as such for a longer period of time. You can see, children, not here also, you can see in your surrounding that if somewhere you people are throwing all the plastic waste, so these plastics are left over there for many, many days. And what happens to these plastic? What are the harmful effect of throwing these plastics directly in our environment? Let us come to those. See, we use shopping bags made from synthetic plastic for carrying goods, and these bags are often thrown out. Such disposal of plastic bags causes the following environment problems. So as I have told before only, that what we people are doing, we are buying things in plastic, we throw the waste of our homes in the, we keep the waste of our home in that plastic and we throw them on the roads, or we just throw them here and there. So what is the harmful effects of throwing these plastics like this? So before going to these point, have you noticed now that if you are throwing this your kitchen waste in these plastics, so the animals, those who are moving in your colonies, those animals, when they try to eat those kitchen waste from that plastic, they are unknown to the harmful effect of the plastic. So what they do sometimes, along with that kitchen waste material, they used to eat those plastics also, and you can find that they are, means what is the ultimate harm to those animals, that they die because of the suffocation problem or because of many other problems in their body. Okay, now let us read what are the effects caused by plastics in our daily life. So it causes soil pollution. So as this plastic do not degrade, it will be there on the soil, and it will pollute the soil because it is made up of chemicals. So obviously it will pollute the soil. These chemicals will cause harm to the soil, and this will not allow the rainwater to percolate down. These second point, see, the blockage of drain and sewer lines. What you do is you don't throw these. You can tell that, ma'am, we are not throwing the plastic in directly in our sewer pipelines or drains. So children, if you are not throwing directly, but what you people are doing is, what we are doing is, we are throwing the plastics in the environment, directly on the roads, on the roadside or behind our house. So by the help of air and water, these plastics, running water or air, these plastic go into the drains, and there they cause the blockage of the drains because these do not degrade. So if they do not degrade, they remain as like it. Third, it causes what I have explained before. Now only it causes the death of the animals who happen to chew these bags along with the food wrapped therein. So it's my request, if you people are throwing also kitchen waste, do not throw on the roads, first of all. And if you are giving to the animals, please do not wrap these waste in any kind of plastic substance. Do keep it at a place so that animals can come and eat those substances. Last point, reduce the percolation of water into the soil. Yes, if the plastics are there on the soil, if the huge number of plastics are piled up over the soil or or on any area. These plastic, as you have read before, that these plastics are impermeable to water, so they do not allow the rain water even to move inside the soil. So these are very, very harmful effects of the plastics. Okay, now what was our question? So what should we do? We should use the plastic or we should not use the plastic? So here we are going to read how to minimize the damage to the environment by plastics or synthetic polymers. So plastic or synthetic polymers are not environment friendly. As you have read beforehand only, that what are the harmful effects of this plastic? So to minimize the damage to the environment by the excessive use of plastic, these are the suggestions which we can follow, gentlemen. First, avoid using things made up of plastic if we can. So that's what I have told beforehand, that it is not very essential part, or it is not very mandatory part of our life. We can substitute this plastic by many things. So if it is possible, we can not. So we should not use this plastic. Second, use shopping bags instead of using plastic shopping bag. We can use the shopping bag made up of jute and cotton. Third, recycle the plastic scientifically. Yes, as you know that we have read a variety of synthetic plastics which are thermoplastic in nature. Thermoplastics in nature means these can be, if you collect these plastic material and you just send into the factory, this can be again heated, reheated, and it can be molded into different shapes and sizes. So use it. So next, do not throw the plastic bags in water bodies and in open. That is how they cause the blockage of drain. Now, last, remember the 4R formula to minimize the damage to the environment by plastic. What do we mean by 4R formula? So these are 4R: reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover. Okay, now look to this picture. See the 4R formula. Refuse means refuse to use the plastic. Second, you can reuse the plastic bottle. As I have told before, that you have seen that many apartments or in many flats, the people are using these plastic containers or bottle to plant the trees. So you can reuse like this. Third, reduce the use. If you are using, also reduce the use of plastic. Do not throw it. If you can do something from it, you can make something from it, then do it. Last, recycle it. Okay, those plastics which can be recycled, keep it at a place and then give it to the persons who are responsible for it. One more diagram we can see here. Okay, that was the same related to these 4 R's. Okay, so believe in these 4 R's. You try to reduce the use of plastic, then reuse if you are having these plastic container in your home, reuse it. Third, if possible, collect all those plastic materials, send it to recycle center, and then you can recover. Recover means whatever the recycled material you are getting from these things, you can again reuse it. Okay, this is all about this whole lesson, children. Let us discuss these oral questions. So the first question, name the monomer of polythene. So the monomer of polythene is ethene. Second question, name the compound which is commercially known as Teflon. So this Teflon is the commercial name, but what is chemical name of this polymer? It is PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene. Okay, again I am repeating, PTFE means polytetrafluoroethylene. Third question, which of the following is a good for making handle of pressure cooker? So if we have to make a handle of pressure cooker, it should not allow the heat to come, means it should be insulator of heat. So the insulator of heat is your thermosetting plastic. Next, fourth question, which of the following is the most transparent? So as you have read in your synthetic plastic characteristics, that most transparent is your polystyrene, which looks like glasses. Okay. Next, fifth question, how is the insulating property of PVC used in industries? So the insulating property of PVC is used in industries for making electrical wires and cable, and this PVC is used as an insulating body upon these wires and cable, which prevent the electricity to come or to get in contact with any other things. This is how, children, we complete this lesson. with the discussion of these oral questions. So children, like this we have completed this chapter. Now I want that all of you go through the lesson very thoroughly by the help of the PDF of the book which I have provided in WhatsApp group. And if you are facing any difficulty or doubt in any of the portion, let me know about it. And lastly, try to do the exercise question. See children, do not get panic. These exercise questions are very direct. I have taught you line by line of this chapter. So you can do it very nicely. If not, means if you are facing then also some problem, then you let me know or text me. Lastly children, I want all of your valuable feedback on all these videos which I have uploaded for you people, so that I can improve or I can add more things for your better learning. So keep learning, stay healthy. Jai Hind children.